Deke has some exciting news to share.
Hello, Deke. Professor Weasley said you had an idea.
Indeed, Deke does. Deke knows that you want to learn about all sorts of beasts. And Deke recently heard rumors of a phoenix nest in a nearby mountain.
A phoenix nest? I wonder if it belongs to the phoenix Natty he mentioned, the one Harlow and the poacher pack are after.
Deke would not doubt it. If Deke has heard of it, surely the nasty poachers have as well, which means it could be in danger.
Well, I'd better go and rescue it then, hadn't I?
Deke thinks so. So majestic a beast should not fall into such vile hands. Deke is not sure why, but Deke feels that saving a phoenix might help to make amends for what happened with Deke's prior master. Deke hopes that you are able to find the phoenix and bring it to the room where it will be safe.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
I know what that means. Merlin trial.
Confringo!
Revelio. Won't get the best of me.
It's true. Eat a big meal, you'll be slowed down, but eat light and you'll be sweet.
Okay. I'm utterly pitiful, this plan.
I'm fine. too late for you to...
Alohomora. I'm only trying to help.
and patrol, little moon calf.
Here's a pleasant surprise. Revelio.
See myself doing this.
Revelio. Travel was before I invented sleep.
Rockborough's famous for someone having a pet troll and not much else.
Rookwood's poachers are already here. Revelio. Be in there. Eight legs is simple. Revelio.
What? No. Keep looking. You've seen how much a single feather is. Just imagine the whole blooming bird.
You should have stayed at the castle.
Imperial.
Cost us out.
I'm sure it'll be. After you're dead.
Dang it! You cannot control this!
You've hurt quite enough.
No!
No! Where's that gun?
It's shameful what you've done to helpless beasts. Revelio.
Things can fly, can't they?
We're keeping people out. Oh.
Let me out, son.
You
lot, go. Let me out, son. He is 10 for weeks. Let me out, son.
The Phoenix. It almost seems as if it wants me to follow it. I need to find it before the poachers do.
Please,
it is again. Revelio. Revelio. Shame you're so foul. Take you somewhere safe. Let's get you back to the room. Deke's going to be pleased. This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Did you find the phoenix?
Yes, Deke. And I rescued it from the poachers. I have it here. It's safe.
Remarkable. Well, what are you waiting for? Deke cannot wait to... Beauty. You keep it close. Professor Weasley and Deke were right to tell you about the Room of Requirement. Look at all you've done, and how many beasts you've rescued. A phoenix is safe now, because of you.
I couldn't have done it without your help, Deke. Thank you.
Deke is grateful for the kind words, and also grateful to have been of assistance to someone like yourself. Helping you do such good for so many beasts has given Deke a sense of peace Deke hasn't known in years. Deke will always be here for you when you need him.
Wonder who lives here.
A lost relic from a catacomb which requires a dark sacrifice.
I know how it sounds, but if this can help you, it's worth the risk.
Does Ominous know about this?
He helped find the scriptorium where we discovered Slytherin's spellbook.
Very well. If Ominous will be there, I'll meet you. We don't have much time. Solomon wants to leave Feldcroft.
What? Leave? Never mind. You need to stall him. Buy us time, Anne. Please.
I shall do my best. I'll be in touch.
Solomon can't take Anne from Feldcroft. Where would they go? When would I see her?
Sebastian.
I can't believe my uncle wants to leave Feldcroft. Anne's going to stall him. She must. We need time.
Time? For what?
I've learned more about the relic. I cross-referenced Slytherin's spellbook with everything in the library on relics and dark sacrifices. That's when I realized something. I believe the relic will only work inside the catacomb.
So we have to get Anne to the catacomb and then conduct a sacrifice. Seems risky.
It'll be worth the risk. Our biggest hurdle may be convincing Ominous. Anne will only give this a chance if he's on board.
And we have to keep all of this from your uncle. If he goes to the headmaster, we could be expelled.
Let me handle Ominous this time. As for my uncle, he's not an Auror anymore. What he doesn't know, well, won't hurt us.
Good luck with Ominous, until we meet again.
I shall let you know when the four of us should meet at the catacomb. Look for my owl. See you soon.
I can do this. I can do this. They will want to help.
Is this where we're meeting the centaurs?
Well, they don't exactly know we're coming, so it's less of a meeting and more of a surprise, I suppose.
Once we tell them about the Snidgets, they'll understand why we came and they'll want to help.
I hope you're right. Perhaps they'll be able to tell that we're sincere. There's something about them that's so knowing. It's almost unnerving.
I suppose they are known for having an air of omniscience.
That's exactly the right word. I just... never mind.
What is it?
It's nothing, truly. We've no secrets to hide.
That's right. We'll simply be honest with them about what we're trying to do. They'll have to help us, won't they?
Yes, of course. You're absolutely right. We'll meet with them, tell them about the Snidgets, and I'm sure to all be fine.
What do you think you're doing here, humans?
Please! We were hoping to speak with you.
Ah! I suppose you'd like a tale for your friends of the time you spoke to a centaur and it spoke back.
No! Never! We're here because we need your help.
Enough! You made a grave error in judgment in coming here, little witch.
Leave them be, Alec. We do not harm the young. It is not our way.
You forget your place, old fool. I'm the leader of this herd, and while you cling to our way, their kind continue to slaughter beasts like us without a care.
From what I can see, they have slaughtered no one. They will leave here unharmed.
Mark my words, Doran. If I ever see them again, it will be all three of your heads.
Foolish children. Do you know what happens to wizards who wander here? Now, follow me before
Golden Snitchets are still alive, and the poachers are after them. They know that the key to finding them lies in the moonlight, but they don't know what that means, yet. Please help us find the Snitchets before the poachers do.
Could it be? In the south, there is a cave within which lies what the poachers seek, a moonstone. Retrieve it and place it in the henge in the forest. I, on the other hand, must go speak with the herd. Find me after you have done this.
I don't understand. So the moonlight mentioned in the journal doesn't refer to actual moonlight, but to a moonstone. What do moonstones have to do with Snitchets? And why was he so certain about where we could find one?
I don't know, but I am inclined to believe him, what with his being a centaur and all.
I am too. It is a shame how quickly he left. What was his name? Doran?
That's what the leader of the herd called him.
Well, if Doran knows something we don't, I'd rather act now and ask questions later. I can head to the library and start looking into the cave he mentioned. I'll let you know what I find.